The story of Rafael Márquez, the Mexican who conquered Europe. Rafael Márquez Álvarez, better known as El Kaiser, was born in Zamora, Michoacán, Mexico on February 13, 1979. Rafa rose through the youth ranks of Atlas since he was 13, which eventually culminated in him making his professional debut at the age of 17. El Kaiser wasn't any ordinary young football prospect. His football IQ was that of a veteran player who could play any of the defensive roles. During his time at Atlas, Rafa played 77 games, scoring 6 times. He helped Atlas reach the final, but they would fall short to Toluca. During the summer of 1999, French football club Monaco traveled to Paraguay to scout players during the Copa America. That's when they were impressed by Rafa's brilliant style of play. That same summer, Monaco made a 5 million euro offer to Atlas. Rafael Márquez just had one question.
Yo pregunté, ¿es Europa, Monaco? Sí.
In Rafa's first season at Monaco, he commanded the back line, which proved to be a huge success as Monaco were crowned League One champions. Rafael Márquez was named in League One's Team of the Season, and he also won the Best Defender award while being only 21 and playing in one of the best leagues in the world. Over the next 3 seasons at Monaco, Rafa solidified his name amongst the best defenders in the world. He would win a cup title in the 2002-03 season. In 2002, Rafael Márquez joined Mexico for the South Korea-Japan World Cup. At only 23, he was given the captain's armband. Mexico would face USA in the round of 16. This was Mexico's best chance of finally breaking the 5th game curse, but Mexico would lose 2-0 with Rafa Márquez being sent off in the last minutes of the match. In the summer of 2003, El Kaiser signed for Barcelona. Barcelona were building a new project to take them back to the top. In his first season at Barcelona, he solidified his role alongside Puyol and quickly became a leader of the back line. But this season proved that Barcelona still needed some new pieces as they failed to win any titles that season. The next season, Rafa proved that he was among the best defensive players at the time, as Barcelona were dealing with many injuries in the CDM position. He was asked to go from playing center back to playing the CDM role, and he did it brilliantly playing behind Xavi and Deco. Barcelona would end a 4-year title drought when they won the league title for that season. In the 2005-06 season, Barcelona would reach the pinnacle of European football, winning the Champions League against a great Arsenal squad. Barcelona would also win the Spanish Super Cup and league title. The new era had arrived, with Ronaldinho, Puyol, Valdés, Eto'o, Márquez, Deco, and of course the young Messi and Iniesta. But over the next 2 seasons, complacency and falling short was the demise of Barcelona, as they failed to win any titles. An unexpected, inexperienced, and politically driven manager was appointed in Pep Guardiola, whose only experience in coaching was Barcelona B. But Pep turned out to be the right man for the job. With precision, possession, and velocity, Barcelona would dominate that season, winning the Spanish Cup, league title, and Champions League, aka the treble. Throughout that season, Rafael Márquez and Puyol would command the back line, while Piqué would watch from the sideline. But in the first leg of the Champions League semi-final, Rafael Márquez would tear part of his meniscus, which would end his season short. The 2009-2010 season would turn into a long farewell for El Kaiser. Pep Guardiola was looking into the future, and in his future, he didn't see Rafael Márquez any longer. Márquez would still be part of the Barcelona sextuple. Márquez left Barcelona as a club icon, winning 11 titles in the process. At only 30 years of age, Barcelona and Rafael Márquez would agree to part ways. Rafael Márquez joined the New York Red Bulls on August 1st, 2010. Many were shocked with the news because Rafa still had many years left in the tank. He even declined a move to Juventus. Over the next few seasons, Rafael Márquez was injury riddled, got many suspensions, and many fans and reporters felt that he wasn't committed to the team. In an interview, El Kaiser confirmed that he was not happy in New York and he was used to playing at a higher level of football. In 2013, León signed Rafael Márquez. Many believed Rafa was done, as he was nearly 34 years, but contrary to that belief, Rafael Márquez captained León to 2 consecutive league titles, becoming only the 2nd team in Mexican league history to do so, while also becoming the first Mexican footballer to win a title in 3 different countries. After playing the 2014 Brazil World Cup and becoming the first player to captain his nation in 4 World Cups, Rafa wanted more as he was desperate to play in Europe again. He joined Italy club Hellas Verona. He wanted to play in Europe so much that he even took a pay cut to feel the European level again. That right there is greatness. While at Hellas Verona, Rafa displayed a slower yet accurate defensive role. He wasn't as fast or as strong, but his individual technique made him play the full season and helped Hellas Verona finish in the mid-table. In December 2015, it was announced that Atlas had signed Rafael Márquez. 16 years after his departure, El Kaiser returned to the club that saw him turn into a star. Atlas would reach 2 quarterfinals while he played there. Around 2018, Rafael Márquez announced that he would retire as a professional football player. but he still wanted to play his final World Cup with Mexico. Rafael Márquez would play his final match against Brazil on July 2nd, 2018. Rafa played the first half, but he wasn't able to play at that pace all game, so he was subbed out at halftime. In his absence, Mexico would crumble to pieces as Brazil would win 2-0. Although Mexico would lose, Rafael Márquez created history again, becoming the first player to captain his country in 5 different World Cups. Rafael Márquez won 2 Gold Cups and 1 Confederations Cup with Mexico. Rafael Márquez set an example to many Mexican footballers that believing in yourself and taking risks is the only way to succeed in life. Rafael Márquez Álvarez retired having won 18 titles throughout his career, going down as the greatest Mexican defender of all time, and most definitely has to go down as one of the greatest center backs of all time as well.
This is my kingdom come, this is my kingdom come. When you feel my